Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commands us to do justice, even to those that at least are evil to us, those that are inimical to our interest, those that are all out to destroy us. In Islam, we are ought to be just to them. وَلَا تَسْتَوِي الْحَسَنَةِ وَلَا السَّيِّئَةِ اِدْفَعَ بِالَّتِي هِيَ أَحْسَنِ فَإِذَا الَّذِي بَيْنَكَ وَبَيْنَهُ عَدَاوَةٌ كَأَنَّهُ وَلِيٌّ حَمِيمٌ وَمَا يُلَقَّاهَا إِلَّا الَّذِينَ صَبَرُوا وَمَا يُلَقَّاهَا إِلَّا ذُو حَظٍّ عَظِيمٍ. Look at these beautiful verses. Allah says, وَلَا تَسْتَوِي الْحَسَنَةُ وَلَا السَّيِّئَةُ. The good deed and the evil deed will not be equal, will not be alike. Good and evil are not the same, and they will never be the same. اِدْفَعَ بِالَّتِي هِيَ أَحْسَنِ. If someone approaches you with any evil action, he insults you, he attacks you, he partakes in character assassination against your personality, Allah says, اِدْفَعَ بِالَّتِي هِيَ أَحْسَنِ. Respond to him by doing what? By something that is better than what he has done to you. Somebody attacks you, respond to him positively. And we can see this in so many teachings of our pious predecessors. For example, Imam Ahmad bin Hanbal, Imam Ahli Sunnati wal Jama'ah, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala be merciful to him. Somebody went to him, attacking him, insulted him, saying that you are a kafir, you are a munafiq, destroying Imam Ahmad rahimahullah ta'ala. And Imam Ahmad was busy praying for him. And his students were flabbergasted. They say, "Ya Sheikh, this man was criticizing you and you are praying for him?" He said, "Why not? If I attack him, fa'ayna al-Qur'an, idha khatabahumul jahiluna qalu salama." He said, "Where is my Qur'an?" So in Islam, even in public office, not all will like you, and not all will love you. Whatever, even if you are a driver, some people, they hate you with passion, and you don't know why. And there is not in any way, there is not even competition amongst you. You are not in the same department. You are not teaching the same course, but they hate you. And even you yourself, you don't even know the reason why they hate you. They envy you. You don't even know what is the actual reason. Because today some people are more interested in hating you than even justifying the reason why they hate you. They don't like you. If you ask them any reason, no reason. Even a flimsy excuse will not be given to you. But they hate you. They envy you, they attack you, they insult you, and they can go to any extent to destroy you. Even in that regard in Islam, for you to reach the peak of ihsan, you have to retaliate with good actions. They attack you, you try to do good to them. That is how Islam is. Isa alayhi salam went to his people preaching to them. And they were busy castigating him. He said to them, "Kafara Allahu amwalakum," may Allah ta'ala protect your wealth. And they say, "La'anaka Allah," may Allah curse you. And he was praying for them, "Zadakum Allahu imanan," may Allah increase your faith. They were saying, "La'anaka Allah." People ask Isa alayhi salam, "People were cursing you and you are busy praying for them." Yeah, he said, "Yes. They always give me what they have in their stores, and I also give them what I have in my store. Do you want me to go to their store and borrow evil actions and pay them back? No. They give me what they have in excess in their store. And what I have in excess in my store, I always give them. So they give me evil deeds and I give them my good deeds. Meaning that I teach them through my action. And I don't know anything except doing good action." That is how Muslims are supposed to do. It's not easy, but we must strive to attain. And that is why the Quran says, "Wama yulaqaha illa alladhina sabaru." No one can attain this except those who are patient, those who remain steadfast. Because as long as you do not at least manage your heart, you did not do your best, it's impossible for you to attain. Because ordinarily, We always retaliate evil with evil. That is what it is supposed to be, ordinarily. But if you look at these verses, you will realize that you are not to pay back with evil. If somebody gives you what he has in his store, and what he has in his store is hypocrisy, conspiracy, character assassination, envy, what you have in your store is nothing but good. So bring something out of your store and give him. That is how we are supposed to do. And this is only what can change your enemy to be your bosom friend, to be your noble friend indeed. That is why Allah says, فَإِذَا الَّذِي بَيْنَكَ وَبَيْنَهُ أَدَاوَةٌ كَأَنَّهُ وَلِيٌّ حَمِيمٌ. That will completely change your enemy to be your bosom friend. Because one person cannot fight. If he does something to you today, he repeats it tomorrow, after tomorrow, and you always try to retaliate by doing something that is good to him. For sure, he can't continue. At least he can remain neutral. He neither help you nor harm you. And nothing can do this miracle except al-ihsan. That is why Allah says, وَمَا يُلَقَّاهَا إِلَّا الَّذِينَ صَبَرُوا. No one can attend this except those who are patient. If you fail to do that, you can attend it. Without a sabr, no one can attend this position. It's impossible.